Many a man has a mighty fire in his soul. Yet no one ever comes to warm himself at it. Passers-by see only a wisp of smoke curling from the chimney, and they go on. I am a man of passion, capable of and destined for more or less foolish things, things I more or less regret afterwards. But the most important thing is to put these passions to good use. For instance, I have an irresistible affection for books, and I want to instruct myself to study continually in different surroundings engulfed by paintings or artwork. I become frenzied with enthusiasm for them, and I make no apologies. It is also necessary to study medicine. There is hardly anybody who doesn't try to understand a little bit about it, who doesn't try to know what it's all about. And look, I haven't the slightest idea what's going on. All this absorbs me, preoccupies me. I have taken a path, and I must continue along it. If I don't do anything, if I don't study, if I no longer go on seeking, then I'm lost. Then woe is me. That's my philosophy. Go on, go on. That's the main point. As molting time is for the birds, the time they change their feathers, so adversity and misfortune brings difficult times for us human beings. And in my case, it is certainly a very long molting. But that doesn't mean I'm an idle man. Besides, there are two kinds of idle men. One is not like the other. One idle man is idle through laziness and lack of character. But there is the other idle man, that good for nothing in spite of himself, who inwardly is consumed by a fierce longing for action, but who does nothing because it is impossible for him to do anything. Through unavoidable circumstances, he does not possess what he needs to become productive. He does not necessarily know what he could do, but instinctively he feels, I am good for something. My life must have a purpose. I know that I could be a quite different man. How can I be useful? How can I be of service? What service? Inside me, there is something. What is it? What can it be? When springtime comes, a bird in a cage knows perfectly well there is something for him to do. He feels it inside him, but he cannot do anything. What the hell can it be? He cannot quite remember. He has only a vague and empty feeling. He cannot describe it. He thinks the other birds are building their nests now, get their little ones, bring them up. And then he smashes his wings against the bars of the cage. But the cage remains, and the bird is maddened by sorrow. Ah, look at that lazy creature, says another bird, passing by. That's what you call a real man of property. But the bird in the cage stays alive. He doesn't die. Outwardly, there are no signs of what's going on inside him. He is behaving himself quite well, and when the sun is shining, he is even more or less lively. But then migration comes, and those melancholic moods return. The children who look after him in his cage, they say, but he has everything he needs. But he looks through the bars of his cage at the storm-pregnant sky, and his rebellion boils, and he cries, you think I have everything? You tell me I don't need anything? I don't need anything else? Fools! Fools! I am not a man of property. I am caged, caged. I beg you, give me my liberty. What a mercy it would be to be free like the other birds. Yes, such a good-for-nothing I resemble. I appear to be such an idle man. But do you know what frees a man from his captivity? Every deep serious affection, brotherhood, friendship, love. That's what opens the dungeon door by supreme magic power. Without it, you remain a prisoner. But where sympathy is renewed, life is restored.